Hello everyone, welcome back to the third video of our FarmCode Lab series. And if you are watching this for the first time, then please subscribe to this channel because we always do amazing stuff with coding. And as always, today we are going to create a JavaScript program to follow people automatically. And most importantly, you can download the script for free and use it in your own account without any limitation. So without any more delay, let's get started. Okay, so at first I am going to show you how to use the program, then I will explain how the program is working. If you are not interested in the coding part, then you can skip that, and I have provided the download link of the program in the description. You can download the file from there and use it on your own. Okay, as today our experimental material is Instagram, at first we have to open the Instagram account. After opening Instagram, you can see there is a section called suggestions for you. This is the list of people Instagram is suggesting you to follow. So at first we are going to see how to follow these people with our program. Okay. Now open the all suggested people page. Then open your console in your browser. If you don't know how to open the console tab in your browser, then just press F12 in your keyboard. Then you can see there is a console tab. Note that I am going to use this console tab to execute the JavaScript program because I had not converted the program to an extension. But if you want, you can convert the program to an extension. Then you don't have to use the console again and again. It's up to you how you want to use the program. Okay, and now in the next part, I am going to copy the JavaScript code from the VS Code. So let's open VS Code and copy the code from here and paste it in the console. One important note I want to mention here that I had made this program to work on suggested people page as well as on the page of someone else's followers, so that we can also follow the followers of some other person with the script. I will cover that part in just a minute. Okay, to control this dual working mode, there is a variable at the top of the script called onOtherAccount. This is a Boolean variable. That means it can only be true or false. So if you are running the script on the suggested people page, then make sure it's false. Otherwise, it will give an error to you. Okay, so with this little tweak, now I am going to run this program to see it in action. To run the script, you have to call a function called follower. And the function has two arguments. The first argument denotes from which user you want to start the process. And the second argument is for the total number of people you want to follow. For now, let's just follow first three people. So I am going to pass 0 as the first argument and 3 as the second argument. Okay, now press enter and you can see that the program is automatically following the persons. You can notice there is a time gap between each follow action. This is because of Instagram policy. If you do it very fast, then Instagram can block you for some time to follow new persons. Okay, so keep a little time gap between each follow action. Okay, now let's see how to follow the followers of some another person with this script. To do this, let's choose a person from the list, and now we are going to follow the followers of this person. So first of all, you have to open the followers tab of this user. Okay, before reusing the script, just refresh the page one time to clear the previous assignments. Now again paste the code in the console, and this time the onOtherAccount variable must be true. One important note here I also mentioned that before pasting the code in console, make sure you had opened the followers tab. Otherwise, you will get an error. Okay, with that, let's run the program again for the first three people. And you can see that the program is following the persons automatically. You can follow any number of persons with this script. Just change the second argument from 3 to any number you want to. Okay, so with this, our first part of this video is done. And now if you want to know the coding part, then be with me. Otherwise, you can download the script from the below link and use it in your own Instagram account. Okay, now let's see how this script is working. To do this, I am going to create this script again from scratch so that you can follow the exact step that I followed to create this script. So let's create a folder for this and open the folder in VS Code in a separate instance. Now let's create a file called autofollow.js. To write anything here, first we have to know what we need to do that task. So open the Instagram for clue. We are going to create the suggested part first. So open that page. Here you can get a basic idea that we need to click the follow button of each person for the task. Okay, so what do we need? We need an array of all the users, and from there we can click the follow button. So to do that, I am going to get the immediate parent of the users. To get this, you can use the inspector, and when you find it, you can just copy the selector of the element. And I am going to copy the selector of the immediate parent of this user's element. And here I am going to use query selector to get that element. And let's save it in a variable called parent div. Now I am going to retrieve all the child elements under this div. We can get this from the children property of our parent div element. And this children property will return an array of the user's element. Okay. Now I'm going to create a function called follower to perform the click action. And here I am going to access each user element individually and perform the click action. So to do that, I need an index to keep track of that. So let's create a variable called index and set default to 0. Also create another variable for total number of users to follow and set the default to 3. Now I am also going to assign 2 arguments in the follower function so that we can manually choose the number of users to follow. Okay, now set the index and total with the arguments and use the index in users div, so that we can get a single element. Now let's test this code and see if it's going right or not. Okay, so copy the query selector part and paste it in console. And if we call children on that, we should get a list of all users element. But I am seeing some abnormality here. Maybe we had selected the wrong parent div by mistake. So let's check it again. Okay, so this is the immediate parent of the user's list. Let's copy it and use this selector. Okay, let's check the code again. You can see that we pass 0 as index and it's providing the first user element. Okay, now we need the follow button of this user's div, and this is the third element on each user div. So let's get the button element from here. I am going to create another variable called button div to save the follow button element. Now let's see in this div how we can get the exact button so that we can click it. You can see that in the button div there is a nested button element. So we have to get this element. We can also get this element from the children property, and the button element is the first element of that. Okay, now I'm going to create another variable called follow button to save the button element. Now let's call the click function on it to click it. Okay, so now the backbone is ready and let's test it if it's working or not. You can see that it's clicking the follow button of the first user. So it's working perfectly. Now on the next part, we have to create a loop so that this program can click the follow button one by one. Okay, so let's do this. Okay, as we also need an interval before each call, let's use the setTimeout function to call our follower with an interval of 6 seconds. In this timeout function, I am going to increment the index on each call and then call the follower function so that the user is different on every call. And one more thing we have to do here is we have to apply a termination condition so that we don't stack in infinite loop, and also the program stops after the task is completed. Okay, so let's do that. Now let's test the function again and check if it is working or not. Okay, now you can see that the program is working exactly in the way we are expecting it. I also want to get some console message when the program is running, so that I can know how many person is followed at the runtime. So let's do this. To do this, I have to get the user details part of the user. And this is the second part of the user div. And you can see here that there is a nested element where the user name is written. So we have to get that element to get the name. Okay, let's do it. I'm going to create a variable called userDetailsDiv to save the userDetails part, which is the second element of the userDiv. Now I'm going to get the username. Sometimes the username is not visible, so that I am going to create a try and catch block. So if the username is not available, then the name is going to be unknown. Okay, now just log the username to the console with the index so that we can track how many is followed by the program. Now let's test the script again. And you can see that now we are getting the username of the user the script is following. That means it's working perfectly. Okay, now the suggested page part is done. And now I am going to make the program able to follow the followers of some another person. In that case, we have to change the parent div because that is different on that page. So let's go to someone's profile and get the immediate parent div of the followers list. Okay, now I'm going to choose the parent div conditionally. For that, let's create a variable called on other account, and I want to choose the parent div of followers page when it's true, and when it's false it should choose the suggestion page parent div. Okay, so let's do this. Okay, now we have to do one more thing. You can see that on the followers page the user div is nested one step down in the list element. So we also have to conditionally handle this. So let's do that in our script now. Okay, now I think the program is ready and let's test it on the follower page. You can see that it's following the follower of another person. That means it's working perfectly. In the main program, I had also implemented a scroll function so that the program can automatically scroll at the end of the list to load new followers and then follow the newly loaded users again. I am not going to discuss it here, but if you want to understand that also, then you can comment below and I will make a separate video on just that. So, with that, we had completed our today's lab test and now go and have some fun with the script and remember not to spam and harm anyone with this. Okay, so see you all in the next video. Until then, please subscribe and share this video. It's really helped me to motivate myself. Thank you for watching.